Hey friends, welcome to the Space and Science Explorer show. Today we are going to learn the invention of the pencil. How is the pencil even invented? And what is the pencil lead made of? And how can a pencil even write? How does the pencil lead write things on the paper? So let's learn about it. So let's get started. Just tell me, how did the pencil mark come from? So what is the pencil lead made of? So the pencil lead is nothing but made up of graphite. In Greek, it's called graphene, which means to write. So what is graphite? Graphite is nothing but the carbon. It is a type of carbon that writes. Carbon atoms together make graphite. So how can it write? So how can graphite even write things? So when we write with graphite is nothing but, if you look closer, the carbon atoms are not here dot, not like that. It's more like sheets everywhere like this. More like pages in a book. They're ordered correctly, right? Like that. So like a sheets in a book, like that. Here also sheet, like the sheet, like that it will be the carbon atoms. So when we, which have weak bonds, means they don't have really strong bonds, means they are so weak that they go away slowly. So when we write and give force on it, then the carbon atoms move like this and go away from the graphite. That's making a mark on the paper. So now let's learn the invention of the paper. I mean, invention of pencil. So first, what happened? How do we know what is graphite? Where did we find graphite in the first place? So we found graphite in the 1500s. How? So in the 1500s in Borrowdale, England, there a storm had happened. So a group of people on the next day came outside and saw that all the trees fell down. So when they were picking up the trees up, then they found graphite. It was more like a big rock. They thought, it's so black, what is this? So the group of people examined it. They put it on a piece of paper. Then to the shock, it got marked on it. A big black mark came on it. So they thought that this should be a good invention. So they got an idea that they can mark the sheep on it. They then got an idea of writing it on paper. So they thought of using it for marking their sheep. So like that, it became the invention of graphite. Once we found graphite in that way. After that, how did we use pencil to write? So graphite slowly became better and came to this shape. Well, but it more looked like a crayon, actually, black crayon, but without any cover on it. Now we have cover on the crayon, right? Like then there was no cover. So like the pencil was a long time ago. But it was really messy, as it would be marked everywhere. It was really messy. Our hands became so dirty at the time. So we used cloth. We used cloth or string or any other thing, or paper. Like that we used to write, so our hands won't get messy. But where did the idea of wood come from? This will make a good light. So the idea of wood came from an Italian couple. So after that, what is the HP scale? So HP scale is nothing but a big scale that tells the mark of the pencil. The higher the scale is, the lighter the mark comes. So like this, it came from Nicholas Jack Quanto. Nicholas Jack Quanto. So he got the idea of making HP scale. Even easier, that he made graphite. So how did he make it? So he used water, then clay, then graphite. And he makes them for 1900 degrees Fahrenheit. That's really hot. Then it became a mixture and then he poured it in the wood of the pencil. Thus making the XP scale. After that, the idea of using an eraser on the top of the pencil came. As the invention of eraser came. So that's how the invention of pencil came, my friends. So H stands for hard and B stands for black. Hard, black. So that's the meaning of HP scale. So that's it for today's video, friends. So don't forget to subscribe, like, hit the bell icon for notifications of new videos. Until my next video comes, goodbye.